Hi everyone, welcome back to another great interview series. My name is Mher, I'm from Vancouver, BC. And today I have the privilege to interview David Mendoza from Toronto. Hi David, how are you doing?
Hey Mher, how's it going? I'm doing fantastic, very happy to have this conversation with you today. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. So David, you turn international students into confident go-getters that hit the ground running to launch their careers, so they can grow on all fronts and make a positive impact on society. So yep. Before I ask you my first question, can you tell us more about you and how you ended up being here, being as the coach of international students?
Absolutely, yes. Thank you very much for asking that. So I am originally from Colombia in South America, and I moved to Canada in 2006. So it's been 15 years since I moved to Canada. It's been a great experience for me, lots of highs and lows for sure, but it's the place that I call home, and it's the place that has allowed me to grow and find myself and work on my passion, which is helping international students to launch their careers. Why I arrived at this decision of doing the work that I do, because before I came to Canada a few years earlier, I went to England when I was doing my bachelor's of business back home. Halfway through the program, I went to England to improve my English as an international student, and it was a life-changing experience for me.
Yeah.
When I came to Canada and I started working in education, I saw that international students were not having the same experience. They were playing too safe. They were feeling inferior for the most part, and the confidence was really, really, really low. Mm-hmm. So they were struggling landing the opportunities that they deserve. And the opportunities that, you know, that represent ROI, because they are investing so much money in education in this country. So that's why I decided to create Orbit 5. We started as a local service in Toronto for international students coming to Toronto. It was a side hustle because I also work as part time faculty at George Brown College, teaching career development related courses and professional communication courses. And I was also freelancing for the travel industry. So Orbit 5 was always in the back burner. But then last year, when the pandemic started, I wanted to make a stronger impact and really support the international student population, because they were having a lot of struggles that the local students do not have in terms of uncertainty, you know, feeling lonely because their families are not here, their mental health deeply impacted, and again, their confidence dropping to the floor because job opportunities that they had landed or internships they had landed, you know, had got canceled because of the situation. So I started doing webinars on a weekly basis, and we have been able to expand our services. We are not a local service in Toronto anymore. We have actually built a global community of international students of support, where people are creating opportunities for one another, and where they come together as a community to navigate the challenges that bring COVID-19. Yeah. And we are transitioning from being just a coaching initiative. We are now an ed tech startup, helping students launch their careers and providing support.
Yeah, in that note, as you mentioned, that due to COVID, anxiety and loneliness start. So my first question for you is, how can job seekers or students can manage stress during the job search? How can they stay motivated? Because some of them, they just finished school maybe in August or maybe in December, and now they're trying to find a job. But as we all know that, because due to a lot of layoffs, once there's a one requisition, a lot of people are applying. So what they can do to have that positive mindset when they're applying for jobs?
Yes. So I'm going to give you three words: mental health, clarity, and strategy. Okay? It's tough to stay motivated nowadays because, again, the situation is so hard, and it's been impacting everyone. That is hard for you if you are a recent grad and you see that there's so much competition out there, and you understand that the market is highly competitive. And you are, again, like juggling so many things at the time to make sure that you stay positive and on track, and that your mental health is on point, right? So it's a lot of things that come into play to stay motivated. It's not easy sometimes.
Yeah.
So mental health, it's the first thing. You must make your mental health your top priority. Without your mental health, you cannot do anything. Yeah. With your mental health, especially as a student, as a new grad, you are unstoppable. Because what you have is energy and drive and ambition, and you're hungry to contribute, to learn, and to grow, right? but you have to make your mental health your top priority. What can you do? So what you can make sure that you build a strong community of support. So make sure that you have a support system around you that can help you navigate the challenges that we are all navigating this year.
Yeah.
Also make sure that you have a schedule or that you are very clear with the activities that you want to do in terms of your job search. How much time are you going to allocate to each of those activities? It's not about like the quantity, it's about the quality of the time that you invest in your job search process.
Yeah.
Approaches, maybe find an accountability buddy. That's someone who can hold you accountable for your growth and for the progress that you are making in your job search process, and you help that other person as well. So together you can, you know, discuss your goals and assess with each other how you guys are accomplishing those goals. So that's first, mental health. Second one, clarity. You must have clarity on the path that you want to walk during your schooling and upon graduation as well. What's happening is that students are just I don't want to generalize, but a lot of students are just going to a classroom, sitting there, getting the content and not doing anything with that content and not trying to apply the learning and the skills that they are developing in that. So by not trying things out, by not developing other projects that supplement the content and the learning that you get in a classroom, you're not gonna have, you're not gonna find the clarity. So you wanna be sure that before you graduate, you are very clear on the path that you wanna walk. And then that ties in with the third word, so that you can be very strategic regarding the approaches that you want to utilize to be more successful in your job search. You have to be extremely strategic, right? Because nowadays, you know that it's all about connecting with people, see who can help you expedite your ambitions and your prospects. And that's, you have to be very strategic with the people that you want to connect with. How are you going to connect with? What kind of interactions you're going to have so that that person is willing to give you their time, and also so they get value from the interactions that they have with you.
Correct.
Doing all these things, I think you're going to go in a mindset that the job search process is going to be an opportunity for you for learning, for growth, and to attain a career that you deserve and that will delight you.
Yeah, those are great tips. I always tell, having a schedule is very important. And don't sit in front of the computer 8 or 10 hours applying for jobs. You know, do your job, network, go out, run, have some interaction with people. I know that we cannot meet in person, but maybe via Zoom, have this informative meetings, and having that people around you that's in your mindset, that's very important.
Yes.
Know who you are, know your values when you're
100%
for a job,
100%.
What's your values? I know that sometimes we need to have kind of a survival job because we need to pay the bills, but don't focus who you are and don't compromise that.
So that is a very good point that you just raised, the survival jobs. Understandable. Some people, they need a survival job because they need to pay bills, especially if they live in cities like you in Vancouver or me in Toronto. These cities are extremely expensive, so you need to pay your bills because nobody's forgiving you that, right?
Yeah.
So you have to do that. So if you have a survival job, absolutely, you get it. But the problem is when you're in your survival job becomes your entire reality.
Yeah.
So you are doing that, but you're not really learning the skill that is going to make you competitive in the field that you are, right? So for students, it's always a good idea to maybe volunteer or to do an internship or team up with other people within the classroom or the classes that you're taking and see if you can develop a side project together where you can gain the skills and hone in the skills that will make you more competitive. By having informational interviews, for example, you can ask people about, hey, what are some of the skills that you think that me as a student need to develop further in order to be more competitive within a hiring process here? And when you listen and hear, from other people, those skills, then you can team up with others and find projects where you can start utilizing those skills so that when you have conversations with someone, again, who can expedite your work prospects, then they see that you have worked on that and you will be able to add value to their organizations, right?
Those are great tips, David. Thank you very much. And for the audience watching or listening for the first time, I'm going to ask David a couple of questions, and I'm going to post them on a daily basis. It will be kind of a journey with us. You can watch all the videos, some of the videos, like and share, leave comments. We are here to help you. And tune in next time for another great question with David.
Mm-hmm. Thanks so much.